Pleasant day to all. I will now be discussing the installment liquidation, and we will start with the preparation of schedule of safe payments. So under installment liquidation of a partnership, even before all of the assets are sold, distribution of cash to partners is allowed. And even before all the losses that may be incurred and charged against the partners are known, nagkakaroon na ng distribution. And it is done by preparing a schedule of safe payments on a periodic basis. Now, the schedule of safe payments to partners is prepared based on the assumption that no more additional cash will be realized from the remaining non-cash assets, and that any resulting cash capital deficiency is not collectible. Like what we have discussed before, ang assumption dito ay, kumbaga, automatically insolvent yung partner with capital deficiency. Cash is therefore distributed to partners who have free interest. Now, a partner's free interest refers to a positive amount of his or her combined capital balances and loan balances after absorbing his share of possible loss from non-realization of the remaining non-cash assets and uncollectibility of any person's capital deficiency. Now, the possible loss consists of the following. The first one is the carrying value of remaining non-cash assets. Kumbaga, ito yung natitira na hindi pa nabebenta na non-cash assets. Kasi nga, ang assumption nito is that this amount will not be realized. And then the other one is the cash withheld for anticipated liquidation expenses and unrecorded liabilities that may arise. So, may cash na wini-withheld. Kasi nga, di ba, during liquidation, there will be some expenses that will be incurred during the process. Now, additional possible loss may also accrue to the partners when a debit balance in any partner's capital account results from the foregoing allocation of possible loss. Now, the deficiency of the partner is absorbed by the other partner as additional possible loss to them. Kasi nga, di ba, it is presumed that the deficient partner will be unable to pay anything to the partnership. That's why yung loss ng partner na yun will be absorbed by the other partners. Now, at some point in the installment liquidation, the distribution of cash to partners based on periodic computation of safe payments will result to partners' capital balances equal to their P&L. Also, cash may be withheld to ensure payments of potential liquidation expenses and previously unrecognized liabilities, just what is mentioned before. Now, in the statement of liquidation, capital deficiency is eliminated before final payments are made to the partners. Okay, for the illustration, we have a problem here where A, B, and C are partners who share profits and losses in the ratio of 2:3 and 5, respectively. And here is the statement of financial position as of December 31, 2021. So as you can see here, these are the assets, and then these are the liabilities and capital. Okay, the info here is the realization of the non-cash assets or other assets. We can see here the carrying value, and then the cash realized, and then here is the loss or gain. So as you can see here, for January, the carrying value is 160,000, but the realized amount is only 130,000, so there is a loss of 30,000. Here, the carrying value is 84,000, the realized cash is only 48,000, so there is a loss of 36,000. And for March, the carrying value is 66,000, but the cash realized is only 24,000, so there is a loss of 42,000. So how are we going to solve this problem? Okay, the first step is to determine the total interest of each partner. So loan to a partner and loan from a partner, if any, shall be added or deducted from the capital balance to obtain the total net interest of each. So as you can see here, nagkaroon ng typographical. But for A, the capital is 60,000. Kita nyo naman dun sa statement of financial position. And then, there is a loss on realization in January of 6,000. Kasi ang nangyari dito, itong loss na 30,000, inallocate na ito based on their P&L ratio. So that would be 30,000 times 2 divided by 10. So that is 6,000. Okay? Now, the balance is 54,000. As for B, the capital is 80,000 and then there is a deduction of 9,000, which is 30,000 times 3 over 10. And then for C, capital is 100,000 and then a deduction for the loss on realization in January, which is 30,000 times 5 over 10. Okay. So next is to compute the possible loss of the partnership to be absorbed by each partner. So this consists of the total carrying value of the remaining non-cash assets and the cash withheld for possible liquidation expenses and unrealized or unrecognized liabilities, if any. So here you can see each partner absorbs a possible loss of an amount equal to the total possible loss multiplied by his profit and loss percentage. So here, nakita natin na yung carrying value na 160,000 is already sold, right? Okay. So 310,000, as you can see here, the total carrying value of the non-cash assets is 310,000 less the carrying value of the non-cash assets that was sold in January, amounting to 160,000. So the remaining possible loss is 150,000. So we just need to allocate this amount to each partner by using their P&L ratio. As you can see here, A will absorb possible loss of 30,000. For B, it's 45,000. And for C, it's 75,000. Okay. Now we can prepare the Schedule 1, which is the schedule of safe payments for January. So as you can see here, the total interest is 54,000, diba? That was computed in the first step. 51,000, 71,000, and 85,000. And then we have to deduct the possible loss, which is distributed according to their P&L. 30,000, 45, and 75. And now here is the possible payment or payment to the partners. A is 24,000 and 26,000 for B and 10,000 for C. So capital balances plus or minus loan balances after sale of asset in January. So after the distribution of available cash to partners' capital balances, which are 30, 45, 75, the capital balances are now equal to the agreed P&L sharing. So any further installment payments in February and March can be safely made on the agreed P&L ratio without preparing a schedule of safe payments. Okay, so that is the first illustration. Okay, so here is the statement of partnership liquidation for January to March 2021. So, balances before liquidation, that is the January, before liquidation in January realization. Okay, so that's cash, and then it's the other asset, and then here's the liability, and then 60, 80, 100, those are the capital balances na makukuha naman lahat sa statement of financial position. Okay, and then as you can see here, there is the idineduct natin yung ano yung sale ng other asset kasi 160 di ba yung carrying amount noon, but then ang na-receive lang na cash is 130, right? So yung 30,000 na loss ay dinistribute among the partners. Ito na yon. Okay, so now here is the balances. So for cash, that is 140,000, and for other assets, that's 150, liabilities, and then here is the capital balances. And then, payment of liabilities. So, as we know, ang inuuna natin ay the, yung mga creditors. Ano? So, babayaran muna ang mga creditors, outside creditors. So, the liability is 80,000. So, you deduct 80,000 and you deduct also 80,000 from cash. So, ang natira na lang na cash balance is 60,000. Okay? And then, after that is the payment to partners. So, as for the 60,000, nakita ninyo, ito na lang yung available na cash, di ba? So, i-distribute na siya. So, 60,000, it is also based on dun sa na-compute natin, ano na schedule 1. So, for A capital, that is 24,000, 26, and 10. As you can see here, here is the balances. And then, here, for the other assets, that's 150,000 for A, B, and C. Ito yun. And then, after that, di ba, as of February, may na-realized ulit. So, magdi-distribute ulit ng loss. So, ang gagawin ay ulitin lang yung process na ginawa. So, as you can see here, di ba, 84,000 yung carrying amount, but it was only sold for 48,000. So, there is a loss of how much? So, 84 minus 48. So, the loss is 36,000. And, i-allocate yung loss na yon among the partners. So, 36 times 2 divided by 10. That's why it is 7,200 for A, 10,800 for B, and 18,000 for C. And then, after that, you will get the balances. So, 48,000 for cash, and then 66,000 na lang sa other assets. As to liability, zero na kasi binayaran na dito, di ba? And here are the remaining balances. Okay? And then payment to partners. So here, you can just allocate it. For example, 48,000 times 2 divided by 10. So that is 9,600, di ba? So inallocate na lang siya based on the P&L of the partners. Kasi nga, itong amount na ito, it will represent naman na eh. It will be equal na to the, kumbaga, wala na kasing ibang consideration. Ano? Kaya, binase na lang sa P&L ang distribution. No need to prepare another schedule. And then, after that, di-zero na ulit yung cash kasi dinistribute na sa kanila. So, after that is the realization naman for the month of March. Okay, 66,000 yung net realizable value. But the amount na na-receive ay 24,000 lang. So, like what is done in the previous month, i-distribute din yung loss among the partners. And then, ito na yung balances. Okay? So, ang payment to partners, ang nangyari, there is a loss pa, di ba, of 24,000. Ayan. Okay? So, meron na silang ano, deficient na yung kanilang ano, kanilang capital. Now is the next is the preparation of cash priority program. Now, it is prepared when the liquidation of a partnership is expected to extend over a long period of time. And then also, installment distribution of cash becomes frequent as cash becomes available. So, it may be more practical to prepare in advance an installment distribution plan, which is more popularly called as the cash priority program. So, under cash priority program, it permits the partners to determine how cash should be safely distributed if and when it becomes available. So, what is the procedure to prepare a cash priority program? Ito yung procedure. Okay. Okay, the first one is to compute the loss absorption balance for each partner. So, what is the loss absorption balance? That is the maximum loss that each partner can absorb and which can eliminate him from any cash distribution. And paano to naku-compute? You need to divide the partner's interest, capital, and loan by his profit and loss ratio. And then the second step is to determine the priority of payment to partners. So how will you determine the priority to partners? So the priority of payment is in terms of the excess of the loss absorption balance of a partner over another. So the partner who has the highest loss absorption balance has the first priority. So tandaan ninyo ito ha, kung sino yung partner na may highest loss absorption, he or she will have the first priority in the cash distribution. Okay? Ngayon, syempre, kung sino yung kasi nga ang ibig sabihin niyan, kung meron siyang highest loss absorption balance, ibig sabihin siya yung least vulnerable to losses. On the other hand, the partner with the lowest amount of loss absorption balance is the last partner to receive. Kasi nga from the term itself, nakalagay, diba, loss absorption. Ibig sabihin, that is the amount na kaya niyang i-absorb, na amount ng loss na kaya niyang i-absorb. Okay? Number three, compute the amount of cash to be paid to the partners under each priority. So, the amount is determined by multiplying the partner's excess loss absorption balance by his profit and loss share percentage. So, here is another illustrative problem. Okay, X, Y, and Z are partners who share profits and losses as follows. So, this 40, 30, and 30. And they decided to liquidate the partnership and they would like to have an advanced cash distribution plan. So, here, you will see the statement of financial position wherein nakalagay dito yung mga capital balances and kung mapapansin ninyo, merong loan kay Z. Okay? So, here is the solution. The first one is to compute the loss absorption potential of each partner. So, how will you do that? By simply dividing the total interest by the profit and loss ratio. So, take note lang ha, dito sa total interest, it is composed of the capital balance and loan. Okay, so for X, that is 100, for Y, 112,500, and for Z, that is 135,000. So, take note lang, nakita natin kanina, di ba, merong loan. Okay? So, ang nangyari doon, may loan ang partnership kay Z. Kaya kasama yun dyan. Okay, divide by the profit and loss ratio. And here is the loss absorption potential. Okay, and then after that, you need to determine the priority of payments to partner. So, ito naman ang gagawin. So, you have to prepare a table like this. So, X, Y, and Z, loss absorption balances, ito yung na-compute dito. Okay, so that's 250,000, 375, and 450. Priority 1 to Z, excess of Z over Y. So, as you can see here, ang may pinaka-mataas na loss absorption balance ay Z, which is 450,000. Sino ang kasunod? Si Y, and then ang pinakahuli ay si X. Okay, so 450 para maging pantay sila, 'di ba? So you need to deduct, okay, 450 less 375, that is 75. Okay? Kaya nakita nyo, binawas dito kay Z, 75,000. So, pareho na silang 375. Okay? So, dito naman, ang pinakamababa is si X, 250. So, 375 minus 250. So, that is 125,000. So, ibabawas yan dito kay Y and Z. So, lahat na sila is 250,000. So, ngayon, alam na natin ang priority. Sino ang pinakauna? Z, kasunod is X, ang pinakahuli ay, si Z, kasunod ay Y, ang pinakahuli ay si X. Next, number 3, compute the amount of cash to be paid to the partners under each priority. Okay, priority number 1 to Z. So, excess loss absorption balance multiplied by the P&L. So, the excess loss absorption balance is 75,000. So, 75,000 times 30%. So, that is 22,500. For priority number 2 to Y and Z. Okay? Priority number 2 sila, Y and Z. 125,000 times 30% and 125,000 times 30%. So, based on their P&L. Okay. Next. So, the information provided by the cash distribution program may be summarized as follows. So, the first one, the first 22,500 available for distribution to partners should be what? Nakalagay. Should be paid yan. Should be paid to kanino? Kay Z. Okay. And then the next 75,000 should be paid to Y and Z, and the ratio of 30 is to 30. And then any amount in excess of 97,500 should be paid to X, Y, and Z. So that is the information provided by the cash distribution program. Now, to further illustrate the installment payments based on the above cash distribution program, ito naman yung assumed cash na available to the partners. As of August, that is 82,500, and for September, that is 107,500. So, to compute the installment payments at the end of each month, here is the distribution for August. So, available for August is 82,500, and then priority 1, which is Z, diba? That is computed as 22,500. And then priority 2, Y and Z. Okay, so as you can see here, 30,000 each. Okay, kasi nga, di ba, ang natira na lang dyan ay 60,000. Kasi 82,000, di ba? Okay, 82,000. So, 60,000 na lang yung natira. So, magkakaroon sila ng 30,000 each. Kasi nga, di ba, 30 is to 30. Eh. So, equal lang sila. Okay? Now, payments to partner. Priority 1, that's 22,500. Priority 2, that is 30,000 and 30,000. So, total, for X, wala. For Y, that is 30,000. And for Z, that is 52,500. Next is the September distribution. So, available for distribution for the month of September is 107,500. Okay? So, di ba may priority 2 tayo, which is Y and Z? So, 75,000 minus 60,000. So, ang matitira na lang ay 15,000. Okay, ibawas natin yan. Yung 15,000 na yan kasi para kay ano yan eh, sa priority 2 pa yan. Tapos ngayon, kasunod yan is priority 3, which is X, Y, and Z. That's 40, 30, and 30. Yung 92,500. Yan naman yung paghahatian for priority 3. Okay? So, bakit 15,000 ito? Kasi nga, di ba, 75,000. Yun na yun. The next 75,000 nakalagay. So, minus 60. 60 na lang kasi meron ng 60, iba minus yung 60 kasi nandito na yun. Okay? So, yun. Para mabuo yung 75,000, may 15 muna dito. Bago paghatian nila tong tatlo. So, here is the payment. So, priority 2, di ba? 7,575. That is the 15. Pinaghatian nila equally kasi 30 is to 30 sila. And then, yung priority 3, it is based on their P&L. So, this is the total payment to X, Y, and Z. Okay? So, it is worthwhile to note that the amount paid to the partners in each installment distribution would be the same regardless of whether they are based on the schedule of safe payment to partners or based on the schedule of payments computed using the cash priority program. Now, to illustrate a cash priority program for A, B, and C, so here is the information given in page 147. So, ito yun. Ito na yung parang pinaka-ano yan, pinaka-summary yan. Pero this is the computation. So, 60, 80, and 100. Ayan, divided by the profit and loss. Okay. So, as you can see, ayan. So, what's this? So, this will be the payment. Wait. Ito kasi ay kay X, Y, and Z. Ano? This one naman ay kay A, B, and C. Okay. Yung una nating naging problem. Ano? Ito yung pinagbasihan niya. So, para ang nangyari, gagawan din ng cash priority program si A, B, and Z. So, pag ginawan sila ng cash priority program, ito yung magiging result. Ano? So, yan. Ganon din naman yung process. As you can see here, ang pinakamataas ay si A. So, para maano siya dito, maging equal siya dun sa second, pag ma-minus rin. Kaya 33,333. Tapos yan, pantay na sila. Tapos para pumantay dito, ito naman. So, pare-pareho na silang 200,000. Tapos, kasunod, yung payment naman. So, priority 1, di ba, kay ano, kay A, 33,333. Times, ano, 20%. So, that's 6,667. Okay? And then the next is the 66,667, which is based on their P&L. So, imu-multiply yun times 20% and then the other one is 30%. So, that is the priority B. Ano to A and B? Okay. So, based on the above priority program, payment is made to partners in January, February, and March as follows. So, for January, diba, ang available ay 60,000. So, to A, 60,000 times 1 over 3. So, that is 6,667. And then, priority to A and B, that is ito na nga. Ito na rin naman yun eh. Okay, tas priority 3, kasi may natira pa eh, diba? Okay, 60 minus 40, that is equal to 20,000. May natira pa kasi. So, based on their P&L, i-distribute na yan. So, total payments for January, sorry, hindi nakatapat ha. For A, that is 24,000, for B, 26, and for C is 10. Okay, so here is the last slide. The computation for February naman. So, as you can see here, that is 48,000. So, nasa priority 3 na tayo kasi na-consume na yung ano eh, lahat nung para sa priority 1. Ano? Kaya yun, i-multiply na lang siya by the, using their P&L. And then, here's the priority 3. Yung mayroon na lang na nakuha, 24,000. So, that will be the, ano, the payment. Ayan. So, I think this is the last slide. So, that's all. Ganun lang. You just need to follow the procedure on how to use the cash priority program, tapos yung schedule of safe payments, tapos yung na-discuss din naman natin kung paano gagawin yung statement of liquidation, di ba? So, ganun lang yung pag-a-apply nitong mga to under installment liquidation of partnership.